Few people realize it, but I'm standing at the site of the largest Revolutionary War battle. Most people associate American cities like Boston and Philadelphia with the Revolutionary War, but it was right here in Brooklyn, New York, that on August 27th, 1776, George Washington and 9,000 American soldiers faced a force of 20,000 British soldiers and their supporters. Even though George Washington and his army were supplied by the French and Spanish with muskets and pistols and cannons, they still were badly beaten. In fact, what is called the Battle of Brooklyn might have spelled the end of the Revolutionary War if George Washington wasn't able to escape to Manhattan with his forces. It is from this spot right here that George Washington snuck his forces across the East River under the noses of the British. The British would then eventually kick George Washington out of Manhattan and would control New York and Brooklyn for the duration of the war. During the Battle of Brooklyn, the British captured over 2,000 American soldiers. The British now had a problem. What to do with all of these prisoners?
They couldn't treat them as prisoners of war. That would be recognizing us as a country. So they were seized as traitors. And early on in the war, they used schools and churches for prisons. They ran out of them very early. So they took old ships, old British ships, dismasted them. They were in the shallows of a few places, but here in particular, Wallabout Bay.
Today, Wallabout Bay is home to the Brooklyn Navy Yard. We're gonna go there right now to see the actual site of the prison ships. We are here now at the Brooklyn Navy Yard, situated between the Williamsburg and Manhattan bridges, right here in Brooklyn. On 16 British prison ships on Wallabout Bay, more than 11,500 people died of disease and starvation. Those prison ships become the site of the most horrific scenes of the Revolutionary War. More people died on those boats than in all the battles of the Revolutionary War combined. So who were they? They were sailors and soldiers fighting in the war. They were private citizens who supported the revolutionaries. They were privateers, groups of American sailors that would intercept and take the supplies from the loyalists, people who supported the king during the revolution. And lastly, there was merchants and smugglers who supplied the revolution. The prison ship martyrs were white and black. They were men and women who suffered and died for our nation. And with them were supporters from around the world, French, Dutch, Spanish, and Latin American. Many of them too died of disease and famine on these ships. But who exactly were the Spanish and Latin American prisoners?
We don't know much about the Spanish prisoners in Wallabout Bay. The British only listed the names of the prisoners, not their origins or the circumstances of their capture. On HMS Jersey alone, about 200 names out of 8,000 total appear to be of Spanish origin. Most were probably merchant sailors captured at sea by the Royal Navy. For example, one prisoner account describes British warships attempting to capture a Spanish merchantman off the coast of Africa.
While we don't know exactly who the Spanish and Latin American prisoners were, and we don't know their stories, we do know what life was like on these prison ships. Here on Wallabout Bay, the most notorious ship, the Jersey, was referred to as Hell. It was made to hold 400 sailors. As a prison ship, it held up to 1,500 prisoners at a time. In the course of the war, the Jersey held over 8,000 prisoners. The British thought that if they brutalized and made life on the prison ships as bad and as deadly as possible, it would incentivize Americans to not support the revolution and stay loyal to the British crown.
You're talking about 1,000 people living aboard a ship with the under ceilings are less than 6 feet. They had about 20 by 20 inches of air and light coming into them. So these are really squalid conditions. They were essentially aground, not a lot of fresh air. Mr. Loring was in charge of the food that they were supposed to get. He was a little bit corrupt. So they were getting spoiled food. They were cooking in something called the Great Cauldron by putting salt water into copper that renders the food poisonous. So there's a lot of sickness, there was a lot of illness. And these people on board every day were offered the option of serving with the British. Many, many died in these squalid conditions.
A prisoner on the ships could see Brooklyn right out the hole. They could go to their British jailer and swear their loyalty to the King of England and join the British Navy and walk off the ship. But all records say that very few of the prisoners did so. It is estimated that mortality rates on the prison ships were over 50%. That means that a higher percentage of American prisoners during the Revolutionary War died on these ships than American prisoners in any other war. In the end, the stories of the brutality of the British prison ships were a call to arms for the colonists.